everybody, so I have a few things to show you today. I've had a little bit of a splurge and I finally went to the Range, and I haven't been there since the beginning of lockdown. For those of you that don't know what the Range is, in Plymouth we've got a few of them because it's where the stores were founded, and it's just basically like a homewares place, but it does everything, crafting stuff, DIY, everything you can think of. But the craft department is really, really good. And yeah, it was just nice to be in a shop and there was nobody else up there. It was just me and my mum, and it was just, yeah, it was really nice to be able to browse. And we had our masks on, but we weren't having to worry about walking into people, and we could just have a really good route around, and they had some really good bargains. So let me get started. Okay, so first of all, I picked up these paper pads here. So I've got two 12 by 12 pads. They have loads there. I don't need, I mean, there's loads I could have had, but I've got some other paper pads coming and I've got my own ones now, so I don't need to go too mad. But these ones here, this one here is called Vintage Dreams, and it's navies, and that's just something I don't have a lot of. And I do love navy and white together. I think it's really nice in projects, but I love that this comes with all these wood grains. So I'll give you a quick flick through. So you have a wood grain on one side, and then you have a blue and white kind of image on the other. So that's a nice kind of layout, scrapbook layout page there. Then you've got a wood grain, blue one, wood grain. Look at these, gorgeous. I had a bedding like this a long time ago, really nice. Again, lovely wood grains. And if you like to take photos of your cards, these are nice backgrounds. You can lay your card on there and take a photo. Again, really nice. So you get two of each design. It's 240 GSM. This is nice. I'm going to use that for a scrapbook layout. Really like that one. I've got some nice blue flowers I can use. Again, that one there's got a background already done there for you. And then that's the centre. So it'd make a lovely gift bag. You've got your two sides there, and then that would be the inside of the gift bag. And then it just repeats again on this side. So that was that one. These are $2.99. And then this one here I thought would go really well with my slider dies, because it was Let's Hear It for the Girls. So it was all about makeup palettes, and you had the lipsticks and all that lot, different stamps and dies. I thought this would go really nice. I know I had papers with it, but there's something about these ones I just thought was really fun. I love the red, white and the black. And these would work well for Valentine's as well. So again, give you a quick flick through. So you've got a black and white speck, tiny little hearts, animal print. that one's like almost like chevron. And then this one here was the one that kind of drew my eye. It's got the ring, strawberries, lips, perfume bottle. What else you got there? Nail varnish, little signs, stars, eyes, glasses, shoes, all sorts. These are great. I actually like them together. Do like a black band or something on the card. I think that would look really good. I can't wait to use them on like my tower cards and things like that. I think they're going to look really nice. This one's got love in tiny writing, so again, great for Valentine's. And you've got the black hearts, the cherries. I think that one's great. More flowers. This is cool. Love that one. And that one says beauty, style, grace, elegance, perfection, beauty, style. And then it repeats. Nice background one there. That's a good one as well. Stars, arrows, that's great. Roses, hearts and lips, more polka dots. And then that's the centre. So I love the cherries there as well. And then it repeats again. So I picked up those two. Then I picked up these pads, and they were £3 each in the clearance section. You get 28 pieces. These are steel for £3. So there was the last two there, so I grabbed them. So this one's got 16 pieces. This one's the luxury glitter card, and this one is your luxury mirror card. And I am low on mirror card. I've got some more that I also picked up because it's not these colours, but it's the Flutterby collection by Crafter's Companion. So Sarah Davis there on the front. So you can see there, you get that lovely turquoise, midnight blue, mauve, and dusky pink. And I'll just, because I'm going to take this out and put it into my, where I keep them all. So the front, those are the different colours. So really, really nice. Super pleased with them. They're really, really nice, thick cardstock. So I will leave those there. And then this is the glitter. Obviously, it's all part of the same collection, so they do go together. So it'd be nice to kind of mix them, because you've got, again, you've got the turquoise, midnight blue, mauve, and dusky pink. So you can see them there. I mean, that actually makes a lovely, because it's that slight greeny colour. It'd be great for snow. Still, it would look nice for a Christmas snow card. But you can see them there. Aren't they lovely? And they're non-shed. I mean, the quality's great anyway. So, and again, you get the little kind of taster ones on the front, which is great that you get them to as extras. So yeah, lots of glitter and mirror card there, which is good, and a bargain price. Okay, and then I picked up these. So these were £1.50 each. Is it £1.50 each? My receipt's in my wallet still. They were under £2. You get 10 sheets of card, 5 of each classic tone. 5 of each classic tone, 10 sheets of card. Okay, ideal to use with Tonic Studio dies, 12x12, weave textured card, acid and lingam free. So I've got the, this is the Magnificent Magenta, so that's the colours you get there. So I've got the two, again, these were the last four left, so I just grabbed these two, and then there was these, and I just thought perfect for right now, because obviously they're the autumnal tones. It's called Heated Hues, and again, same description there. So yeah, just, you know, go through cardstock so quickly, so it's good to keep stocked up, and they are really nice colours. And these ones are, you know, I'll probably use a few now, but they go through into spring anyway, so that's good. And then I picked up these two here. So these were full price, which was £3.99 each. I mean, that's still a bargain for 20. They're 250 GSM, so again, you could use them to make your, you know, gift boxes and bags, but also as your card base. And this is the Anita's gold Miri board and the silver Miri board. And it's a really nice silver. It's not, I'll just show you here. There you go, you can see. It's just a really nice, it's almost matte in a way, but there is a real nice shine to it. And you can see the gold there. I don't need to take that one out. But again, these are, that's all going to be gone on Christmas cards. And I actually needed some to finish a project today, so I'll be able to do that and get that filmed. So yeah, just kind of stocking up on the basics, but also getting a few bargains along the way. And then this one here I saw. Now, last year when I was at the craft show, I picked up the 3 snowmen stamp sets for pennies. That I think they were like £2.99 each or something like that, and I made one card with them because I got them in the November. I'd already made a lot of my projects, so I didn't really get to use them so much. And then I saw this reduced for £1.99. I mean, it was only £2.99 apparently according to the stickers, so that was to me still good. But it matches the stamps, and I just thought I can make some really nice Christmas cards with it, because I've got a few flying, floating kind of ideas in my head, and the snowman works perfectly for that. So it's just really nice. 8x8, very cute. You've got some lovely imagery here, and obviously it's the official Raymond Briggs merchandise, so all of the official images there, which are just so cute. And I love these background ones, because I can use that on other things as well. So yeah, I just grabbed that one. Then I grabbed the paper posies. These were down to 99p, and this pad was £1.99 or £2.99. and I've adored this collection. I used all of my 12x12, I've got just scraps, and the 6x6 pad I've got, only got things like the, maybe some of the blues left, none of these ones. So I just thought for that price I'm going to grab it and just keep it there, because it does make some beautiful cards. And I've still got some of the decoupage toppers, so it'd be nice to match them up. And I thought while I was there, I've picked up the wooden matching shapes there as well. I have used a lot of them. I think I've maybe got 2 left, so yeah, I thought I'd grab those. So I don't tend to, I try not to buy repeats of things, but because I've enjoyed them so much, and I know that they were popular with cards that my friends got from me, so if they did ask for another kind of card similar, I've got the stuff there to be able to do it. And still in the clearance bin, these were both with these orange stickers. I just hadn't put them on some things as well. So this here was 30p. I just thought they're going to be nice just to pop on my cards, like fill in little areas. So these make little flags. So you've got your little sticks there, and you just wrap them around the top. They've got the little flag tails on the ends there, so it's just Dear Santa. Hell's Couple Ditch collection, that would have been, it was for Trimcraft. So I don't remember the deer. Oh yeah, no, I do remember it actually. So I got them, and then I never had these last year, and it's the Dovecraft The Magic of Christmas, and they're metal snowflakes, little charms. I thought they'd look really nice, because I'm bound to do maybe a Christmas album, and any gift bags and things like that. And those again were 30p, so again, it was such a bargain. And those were £1 again, or was it 50p? I can't remember, but they were cheap. They were all in the clearance. The Wellington boot I still have a few of, but the birds have all gone, so I've stocked up on some more of those, because I do love using them for my 3D makes and so on. And I picked up this very bizarre glitter pom-pom garland. I love pom-poms, and pom-poms with glitter are just even better. But I saw it and I just thought, I know I can do something with this. It may go into some form of wreath. I might use it for handles on gift bags. I think that would look really fun. It's just, it's got the Grinch kind of feel to it. I just thought for £1.99, for the amount that you get, I needed to get it. So so I'm now thinking of a fun project. So if you've got any ideas, pop them in the comments section and I will check them out. It's really soft and I know I can do something fun with this. So yeah, there was three in the bin. I didn't think I'd need three, 1.8 meters. So I just picked up the two there, but for $1.99, I thought that was pretty good. I don't know what it was to start with. It probably wasn't too much more because it doesn't actually say on there. But anyway, yeah, that's what I got. And then I picked up some more foam. So lots of people always ask me where I get the foam from. It's just in the children's department. So and you can get it in the pound shop. It's in the pound shop, it's kind of cut into shapes, but you can still use it to die cut. But it's how I add dimension to my sentiments or any kind of different dyes that I might use. I tend to always want them to be a bit dimensional. So I've got this pad here, which has got all of your darker tones, and then you've got white and cream there, and then this one's a bit more colourful. And yeah, I use them a lot. So they're very inexpensive, a few pound, and very lightweight as well. But yeah, if you like to make things more dimensional and you don't want to cut it out multiple times in paper, if you just cut it out once with the foam and then once of the actual image and you stick that on top, yeah, you've got a nice dimensional element for your cards or your 3D projects. So I picked up those. And then I treated myself to a cordless glue gun. I have been eyeing this up for a while. There is nothing wrong with my Sizzix one. I really enjoy it. However, it just, I don't like having it on display, and the wire does irritate me sometimes, I'm not going to lie. So I Googled it, and I had it on my Amazon basket for a while, and I remembered I'd put it back in there. You know, you can save for later or whatever. So I went back to it and I checked out the reviews. The reviews are really good, and I've been using it now. I've used it maybe three or four times, and it's really good. So you have a USB lead here. So this will connect like so. Now you can use it when it's on as well, I believe. I don't think I have, but I'm sure you can, because it does charge. If I just pop it in here, so you can see now the light's on. Just make it out there, the red light's on. When it goes green, that means it's fully charged. It has a little stand there. I'm going to take that back off again now, and it shows it's on there anyway, even though it does need charging, it will still work. Glue sticks in there, you get 30 glue sticks. So I've got them all there, I'll put them in my drawer, and you get a little mat as well. Now it doesn't drip, I've not seen anything drip from it, but I've got some really good hacks that I'm going to share for using your heat gun, which I think some people are going to like, so that video will be going up very soon. It takes about 4 minutes to start kind of, you know, being soft enough for you to squeeze through, but if you can leave it a bit longer, when I'm coming in to start projects, I tend to turn my glue gun on, and then, you know, it's there, it's ready, and it's piping hot when you go to use it. Not very heavy, really comfortable. Like I said, I think it's a really, really good product. I'm very, very pleased with this one, but I wanted to use it a few times before I kind of shared it with you, just so I can be a bit more honest with my opinions on it. But so far, I'm very impressed, and it was $11.99, I'm going to say, which again, I thought was really good. So I'll share the links as always. You also get these. Now, I do have the pink ones here, which are by the Stick to Anything brand. It's little silicone finger protectors, so you can, you know, push the hot glue down with your finger. You see me do use this sometimes in my videos, so you don't get any of that burning your fingers. But it's good that they give you quite a few in here. So I haven't actually taken these ones out. I'll put them with that one there. I don't think I need this many. I can't imagine I'm going to be going through them like that. But I guess if you're someone who uses a glue gun a lot, now these are more like rubber gloves, like just on your fingers. But there you go. I guess if you're doing maybe quite a lot of gluing, you can put them on a few fingers, but they're there anyway, and you can just take those off and yeah, reuse them. You don't have to throw those away. You've got instructions there, so yeah, I'm pleased with that one. So yeah, it's already, I can feel it. Oh yeah, don't put your finger on that bit there, but it's got nice and warm already. So I'm just gonna pop that to one side. Then I got a couple of magazines. Now I have already used the creative stamping one because I showed it in a recent Facebook Live. So this is issue 88, and within this one here you get the A4 stamp set here, and it's the Floral Christmas, and this section here is the John Next Door brand. So I was very fortunate, I got to actually use this and do a commission maybe about 2 months ago when I'd done the commission, and this is my card on the front. So I was super chuffed to see that in there, and this is actually the first time I've done a commission for this magazine. And being a huge fan of Creative Stamping magazine, it's something I've collected myself for many years. I have lots of the stamps. It was very, very it was a very happy moment when this dropped through my door and I saw my card there. So that's just, you know, inspiration on some, you know, just a card idea. I've done this one here and I'll just show you again. I'm not going to show everything, all the other inspirations, because it's a nice surprise, but I don't mind showing the ones I've done. So there's the cover card. This one's really nice. I just used this stamp here and just stamped it all over. Done a circular kind of wreath effect there. And then I've done this one here, which is like a little, you can have it as a place setting as well, your name setting, what you want to call it. And then I've done a pop-up box card there as well. There's some really lovely makes in this magazine as well, using that free stamp set. And you also get the die there, and that die which will cut this one and that flower there, which will layer up on that one as well. But you get the lovely big poinsettia there. You've got, this is nice, it's like the mistletoe. You've got the rose flourish, you've got pine cones there, and the ferns. It's really, really nice. The Merry Christmas, peace on earth, sent with love, and warmest winter wishes, and just for you. Oh, and joy to the world. She got a few sentiments, plus the sentiments in the John next door. So yeah, that one is the Creative Stamping issue 88. And then this is the Hunkydory Premium Magazines. This is volume 12. Again, I get these sent to me for free because I've done some of the commissions for them. But I also like to share them. And then a lot of these go into my giveaway box for the Facebook Lives that I do. So in this one here, you get this die here, which I can't remember, Season's Greetings. Oh yeah, it says it there, Sam. So you get a stamp set there. Put it on, there we go. So it says Gnome for Christmas, as in home for Christmas. Christmas wishes, you've got the little stocking, you've got this nice little garland effect, and then you have here three gnomes that are all standing on top of each other, which is very, very sweet. I've actually got one of their larger edgeable stamps, or edge it they call them, and it has, I believe it's penguins, and I'm going to use it on a tower card. So yeah, I saw this one, it's super cute. In fact, I'll probably hopefully get to use this, because in my brief for the commission, mine was just shaped cards. So and they wanted me to kind of focus more on the cut out pieces, or the pop out pieces that you get, which Hunkydory are known for. I didn't get to use the stamp set, and this is their For Lovers Stamps stamp sets, which obviously I really like. So I'll pop all that back in there in a moment. There's the magazine. So again, I'll just find my makes. I mean, I love that. I've done something similar before on my channel with the tea lights, but I like the size of that one. They put three. I think mine, I've done four or five. So I quite like that kind of more, I guess, smaller version. That was one of mine there. So I've done the TP card. Worked really well with that. I've done a little rosette and little cluster on the front. And here's some of the makes. So there's the, they called it shape shifting, this feature. So that's the TP card there. Then I've done this center easel with the, that's one of the, I'll show you them, it's all in this pad here. There you go, you can see it actually, it's this lovely image here. That's what I used in the center of the easel. I've done the triple cube box. That was really fun actually, I like that one, with the gnomes on the fronts there and the sentiment in the middle. And then I've done this one, which is a top folding, but I've done a very, very thick kind of top part, and I've scored the card. This is all in the kit. And made this big bow on the top. It looked really good. It's, you see it, you kind of appreciate it more on the side really, because you get to see all the dimension there. But it's, that was a, yeah, I like that one. And this is a box card using the whole piece of A4. So you can see there, it's kind of, and this bit sits out. Again, I've done similar before on my channel, but it's just nice ways to show off the paper. And that's all in here. Again, I'm not going to open and take all this out, but you get loads. You've got your card stocks there, and you've got all of these pieces to pop out and make some lovely, lovely things with. So yeah, that's the volume 12. And if you'd like to try and get your hands on this one, then you just have to watch my Facebook Lives. They're every Monday and Friday at 2 British summertime. And I will always make something, and then at the end I will randomly select a comment, and that person will win whatever the giveaway prize is for that day. And we have some really great stuff, because a lot of it's been donated as well, so there's some fantastic prizes. But at the moment we're trying to make sure, I'm trying to make sure that I get the Christmas stuff out to people, the Christmas giveaway pieces, because then you can use it this side of this year rather than win it maybe in February or something next year and not be able to use it straight away. So yeah, so that one is going to go into the giveaway box. And then I received some wonderful friend mail. So this has come from my lovely friend in Ireland called Simone, and she's been following me now for a while. She's a great support, really, really active on our Mixed Up Crafters Facebook page. She has our own YouTube channel as well, which is Blonde Cards and Create, I believe. And she messaged me a while ago, and we chat anyway, but she said, oh, I'd love to send you something. And she asked for my clothes size and my favourite colours. And then this has arrived. So she's done the wonderful Book of Tricks easel card, which I showed how to make maybe a year ago now. And I was saying it's so nice to get a card back to me that of a style that I've created, because obviously I make cards for everybody else, but my mum obviously makes a lot. But you know, it's just, it's nice to receive it. So when I saw this one, it's gorgeous. It's got this little charm here and it says, thanks so much. And it's got this crafty feel to it. I love the colours. Pink again, I think pretty much everybody knows I love hot pink. And then inside she's just put just a little note. Sam, you are such an inspiration to me. Such a wonderful person too. Your friend in Ireland, Simone. So then her and her husband, well, her husband, she said he took my logo, which I'd sent to them anyway, and he edited it, and then they put it onto all of these different items. So I have here a water bottle. So here's my Mixed Up Craft logo, and I love this. It's just so nice, and I've got the clip here, and I can obviously change, so I can have it with that. I mean, I'm not sure what I'm going to use yet. That's just your, like, I guess, sports kind of lid. And then you've got that one to screw on there, but that's really nice. And then I've got these mugs. Now I've actually got three of each, so I've got plenty of them. I'm actually going to keep one of each in my craft room and put my pens in them, so I can get to, you know, because unfortunately these kind of things, when I use them for making my cups of tea and they go in the dishwasher, or these ones I probably won't dishwash, to be fair, but anyway, they're going to probably end up chipping at some point, you know. Unfortunately it does happen. That's why I thought I'm going to two of them, one of each design, is staying in my craft room, and that way it will last forever. So this one says Made to Surprise, which is my brand with Craft Stash, and then here again is my logo, Mixed Up Craft. Aren't they lovely? And they're good drinking mugs as well, nice size. So I loved those. And then I've got these here, which are two shopper bags, and they have my logo on. Now I use these all the time. I don't, you know, use any plastic bags if I don't need to. So I use these kind of things a lot. They get rolled up and put into my handbag, so I've always got them handy. So again, one of them is gonna stay in my craft room. I'm gonna keep this one hung up just so it's nice and, yeah, won't get marked or stained. And then this one I'm gonna take out and show it off, because I think it looks wonderful. Done a really good job. I had a lovely one from Louise Beauregard, who's another member of our Mixed Up Crafters group, and she sent me one with my Made to Surprise on it. So now I've got one of each, which is really good. So I'm super pleased with that. And then I have some clothing. I can't believe it. Again, I said to Simone, she actually did make me cry, because I'd received, the magazine had come through and I'd seen my card was on the front, and that made me really happy and a little bit emotional. And then this came through, and Simone's lovely card and words, and it was just a really nice morning. I felt really positive. I mean, I'm pretty positive anyway, but it's just reassures you and just makes you realise that there are really good people still around in this world. And yeah, I try not to get too caught up in news and all the bad things that are going on. It was just a nice, positive day. So look at these. I've got the Fruit of the Loom t-shirts here. So they're really nice quality. And this one is my logo. Again, love the pink colour. So I was saying it's such a shame that I'm not able to do any classes or anything, because this would be like my uniform. So they will definitely obviously be used. And I look forward to, yeah, wearing them. So I've got a lovely pink colour. And then this one is brilliant. I craft so hard, I sweat glitter. This is, I mean, you can wear it all year round, but with Christmas coming, you know, it's definitely going to be used. And I do have another launch on Hachanda coming up. I need to check the colours, because you do get told the colours that you can wear on TV. I'm sure pink was a good colour. So I may well wear this one, because I can't wear anything with my, obviously, my branding with the Mixed Up Craft on. But this here, Weekend Forecast, Crafting with a Chance of Chocolate. I thought that was wicked. And I love chocolate. And I just think that's great. And I just love the glitter. It's not, doesn't shed or nothing. It's been so well made. So I love that one. And then this one. Again, on that lovely pink colour. I'm going to wear this with jeans, I think. I love it. Really, really do. I was, again, so touched that somebody, well, Simone and her husband, have gone to this, you know, effort to make this for me. So yeah, it's hugely appreciated. And yeah, I'm gonna display some of it and yeah, get these, give them an iron, and start wearing them, I think. Okay, so that is most of the things that I've got. I can't get it all in, but I will link as much as I can as possible. I'll look out for those paper pads because they're obviously a bargain. The magazine's fantastic. The stamps are always great, so I always rave about that one. And definitely this, I think you're going to really like it. If you don't like the leads getting in the way, and it's just handy as well if you're doing jobs around the house. You know, having, you know, not being kind of restricted with the lead is really good. So yeah, definitely look out for that one, and hopefully you can get some of these bargains that I managed to get from the range. So thank you as always for watching, and I'll be back again very soon with a tutorial featuring some of this lovely stuff. So I'll see you all again soon. Bye.